Hi, I'm Alex Ronsley. Welcome to another edition of Three Things, the show where we take a look back at what happened with the Kings over the last set of seven and get you set for the week ahead. Two games at the Hap this past week, a 5-2 loss to Victoria on Tuesday before Remembrance Day on Wednesday, and then a home date with the Langley Rivermen and a 9-3 victory over the Mainland Division club. Let's get started with three things you might have missed from the last week. Thing you might have missed, number one, was the teddy bear toss goal on Friday night. Now, Friday was the annual teddy bear toss game, and almost 1,000 people in attendance there to take in the action against the Langley Rivermen on Friday night. It's one of the most anticipated goals by players and fans alike through the year. This year, Kyle Betts didn't keep fans waiting very long.
As it'll be Cam Gianetti, Matty Saharchuk, and there's a third one that we'll try and pick up as the game goes on. Kings the other way, here's Mullen. In the slot, they score! Kyle Betts! And it's the Teddy Bear Toss goal! Oh, how pumped is Kyle Betts to rush down the ice? We said we didn't have to wait long. It's a minute and 22 seconds in. And the crowd still throwing items under the ice, and the Kings off the bench to help clean it up. Great speed down the right side by Tristan Mullen. He teed up that goal as Mullen down the right side in across the attacking blue. Drew the Langley defenseman in towards him, was able to slide it to his left, and Betts roofs it upstairs. For Betts, his seventh of the season, perhaps none bigger. And the Kings a 1-0 lead.
A minute and 22 seconds in. That's all it took as the Kings took a 1-0 lead. Now, more video from that game on Friday night is available here, including Jake Kohlhauser's first BCHL goal, as well as our post-game chats with Kyle Betts, Nick Halasian, and Brock Sawyer after the game. Thing you might have missed, number two, is our alumni stat pack, edition number 5 coming out on Monday, featuring an update of all the stats of Kings playing NCAA collegiate hockey, as well as pro hockey across North America. Now, a couple of notes to take away from this week is a pair of former Powell River King netminers who broke school records over the weekend. That's Brett Magnus, who set a new Sacred Heart record for most saves in a single game with 62, as well as Michigan Tech senior Jamie Phillips, who set a new school record with 8 NCAA shutouts in his tenure there so far. That beating out the old record of 7, and he's still got half a season to go. Now, also some video coming from this week's edition of the Stat Pack involving former King forward Matt Galbowski, currently with the Rochester Americans in the American Hockey League. Now, a link to this week's Stat Pack is available in the description down below. Thing you might have missed, number 3, was Remembrance Day in Powell River on Wednesday. The Powell River Kings were in attendance at the ceremony in the townsite neighborhood of Powell River. Of course, the ceremony at the Cenotaph was the highlight, as well as the March Past following, which honored several Powell River RCMP veterans. Of course, the Kings very honored and very proud to be able to say thank you to those who give so much. Now, honorable mentions for this week for things you might have missed is a big announcement from TSN, Canada's sports leader, as they have upped their commitment of broadcasting NCAA hockey games this season. In total, 44 games, including the Frozen Four, will be broadcast live on TSN. The schedule is already underway, and you can check that out in full with a link in the description down below. So the Kings hit the road this weekend. 3 games in 2.5 days. Let's get you set with what's to come in the next set of 7. Thing to look forward to, number 1, is a huge test for both clubs on Friday night as the Kings and the Chilliwack Chiefs lock up for the first time this season. Now, it won't be the Kings' first visit to Prospera Center this year. They played and won 2 games at Prospera at the BCHL Showcase back in September against Coquitlam and Surrey. The 15-5-1-2 Chilliwack Chiefs, though, will pose a much bigger challenge for the Kings. The Chiefs will carry a 9-game winning streak into the game as well. That's the second highest streak of its kind in the BCHL right now. The Chiefs 7th in the league on the power play at 20%, 5th on the kill at 82.5%. However, the Chiefs' last 3 games have come against sub-500 teams, so it'll be a test for Chilliwack as well against a resurgent Powell River side, as well as a chance for the Kings to see how they stack up against one of the top teams in the BCHL. Thing to look forward to, number 2, is the game in Merritt on Saturday, just because of the unique venue. Now, we talk about this every single year, but the Nicola Valley Memorial Arena in Merritt is one of the league's best home ice advantages. Why? It is small. The 8-16 0-2 Merritt Centennials playing a little bit better than their record indicates, but they have a fantastic home ice advantage. The zones are incredibly tiny. The rink is very, very narrow, more closely resembling a curling rink than a hockey ice sheet. Now, it is a tough venue for Palrover to win in, as well as outside a tie a couple of seasons ago in 2013. The Kings haven't won there since the 2010-2011 season. And finally, thing to look forward to, number three, is a visit to the Prince George Coliseum on Sunday afternoon to face the Prince George Spruce Kings at the end of this three-game and two-and-a-half-day road trip. It's always a grind when you go up to Prince George, but the Kings have been successful most recently last year, taking a 3-2 victory away from BC's Northern Capital. It's leg two of this year's BCHL Battle Royale as well, the Kings winning leg one a couple of weeks ago in Powell River by a 6-2 score. Added intrigue into this one, as it was a couple of weeks ago, former Powell River King assistant coach Chad Van Diemen, now the head coach in Prince George. The Spruce Kings have been struggling a little bit this season, but no doubt they will lift, trying to take advantage of a road-weary Powell River team. It's three games in 2.5 days for the Kings this weekend. It starts Friday night at Prospera Center in Chilliwack against the Mainland Division-leading Chilliwack Chiefs. Saturday night, it's up to Merritt to face the Merritt Centennials before wrapping up Sunday afternoon in Prince George against the Spruce Kings. All three games live on the network at 95.7 Coast FM, beginning 20 minutes prior to opening face-off each night. That'll do it for this week's edition of Three Things. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Alex Ronsley. We'll talk to you through the week and then kick it all off on Friday at 6:40 live from Prospera Center for our pregame show coverage of the Kings and the Chiefs on Friday night. Bye now.